get started like I did last time. These aren't going to be my own experiences and my own thoughts and my own feelings about certain things I'm going to be talking about in this video. So, do not take my words as gospel. If you have different experiences with different things, that's good. That means we're all different people. And if you experience like things differently than to like me or to someone else, that's good. But just know that my words are my words only and my experiences only. Maybe someone has a similar experience, but this is mine and my own. So don't take these as like gospel or like as like pure fact. So yeah. So let's get started. Finally. So first, I wanted to talk about like socializing. So when you're in university, you are going to be surrounded by a lot of people, and you are going to be very overwhelmed at first. Or when you get there, it could be like, I wish I had some help. This is the first and biggest thing I suggest you do if you are someone who's autistic or know someone who's autistic or someone who's neurodivergent or has some kind of like other like disability. Go to your school's disability services. They will help you a lot with trying to figure out how to start your college like experience. They will help you with like classes. They will give you resources for like jobs and getting to classes or figuring out like what you need for your classes and stuff like that. I signed up for my school's disability services, and my favorite thing is priority registration. So priority registration is basically where you get to register early. And having that is really good. And they also help you plan your semesters as well. Well, I don't really have a hard time planning for some of my semesters, but if you want to talk to someone and see what a good plan is, talk to your advisor at your school's disability services, because that will be a good thing for you to use. It's a good resource for anyone who feels overwhelmed. Find that place. But if your school doesn't have a disability services, go look for like a success center or like a student help center that they'll help you with finding information that will help you. And yeah, like I know a good amount of stuff already from being in community college, but if you're going straight to a university, I suggest you get that help, because I remember for like my first like year, I didn't have a lot of help. I tried to do all this stuff on my own, and then I realized that I was doing a little couple of things wrong until I went to like the disability services office, and they told me like, oh, here's how you should really kind of be doing things to get like the most efficient like set of stuff. So yeah. Next is like schedule planning. For me, I need good time to just relax and sit and kind of decompress after being in a lot of classes. So what I like to do is I like to like have only a couple of days where I'm doing classes and have like a couple of days where I'm just doing nothing. So like for me this semester, I have Tuesdays and Thursdays off, but I do still work, but I work only 2 hours those days, and so I get a good amount of time to relax, to unwind, and do different things like that. And like what I talked about with my meal planner last week, I tried to plan my meals around like where I don't have to do the most stuff during those days. Like maybe I'll do something like a very like simple meal, or I'll have leftovers. So yeah, and then yeah, that is the main thing. Is if you, I suggest like just nice podcast or some of your favorite music and just put this on. It'll drown out the kind of sounds of the outside because these ones are pretty nice and noise canceling. So put them in your ear and just walk out the door, play your favorite music. Sometimes I like to play on my way to class or work. I kind of like to hype myself up with some nice upbeat music, or when I'm on my way to class trying to unwind and decompress on my walk back to my apartment, I like to put on a nice podcast. Some of them I like to listen to are Full of It by Olympia Avalanche of Novembia. It's on her Patreon and you can listen to it on the Patreon. I believe their lowest tier is $1 something, and you get that podcast for free, and you get that podcast with that. Or I like Violating Community Guidelines by Brittany Broski and Sarah Schauer. I like to listen to that too, just different little podcasts on my way there. My walk is usually about 15 minutes. It's just a nice short listen. So yeah, I like doing that. Or there's this podcast called Two Hot Takes that reads Reddit stories and stuff based on a certain theme. They do a lot of crazy stories, and I like listening to that. So wireless headphones, podcast, favorite music, or maybe even an audiobook, anything that will help you just kind of drown out the noises of the outside world while you're on your way to class. Alright, now, time for the hardest part, socializing with your classmates. Yeah, I know that especially for me, socializing with your classmates is kind of hard for a lot of people, especially myself. Whatever, one of my classes, I already have a really good friend there, so I don't have to worry about me, trying to interact with new people. So yeah, thankfully for me, I don't, have a lot of people that I interact with that I don't know. Maybe there's one or two classes where I don't know the people. But yeah, and my classes are pretty small, so I at least get to know people, for a small little while. It's nice just to see people walking around, seeing oh, look at that person, I've seen that person in my class before, or something like that. So yeah, socializing with people is always the hardest part of, in a new class. What I like to do is sit next to someone that you feel like you will connect with the most, either with someone that you feel has the same kind of aesthetic as you, or someone that you feel would be really nice. So I like to be with people that are kind of a little bit more extravagant, if they have colorful hair or really pretty makeup or a nice outfit or something like that. Or if I see something they have anime stuff on their backpack or on their water bottle, because if they're getting their water bottle and they have anime stickers on it, maybe that will give you a little bit of indicator. So I would if you want to just kind of interact with someone that you feel you have the most connection with, you don't really have to connect a lot. You can just maybe just say hi, but if you don't want to, you don't have to. either. So what I like to do is at least try to like have like a planner or something. Like I like to do planners. And it's like, oh, like a planner, like you sure I'm gonna be able to keep up with that. Try to make it a little bit of a routine, like especially for me, if I can make it into a routine of something I can do and to make it fun. Like I have a box of stickers and colorful pens and glittery pens and stuff like that to make my journal look really nice and pretty. And that's a good way to keep up with a journal because you get to make your stuff pretty and nice and you get to make it a little bit of fun. So yeah, try to write down and jot down like all the like dates on your planner of like all the assignments that are due. And try to make it cute as well. And it also makes it a little bit less stressful because it's nice and colorful and you're kind of distracted. So yeah, well, I think really that's about it. If you guys want me to talk about anything else and maybe do a part three, but just let me know. Let me know if there is anything else. Like ask me some questions about like college life or anything else. I've been wanting to do a little bit of a Q&A, so maybe ask me some questions about like just me or college or anything else, and maybe I'll do another Q&A. To be able to do that, so ask me.